5 best Star Wars The Clone Wars story arcs. The Star Wars universe has grown immensely in the last 10 years or so, and we're seeing characters and storylines carry across multiple projects and mediums. While the first season or two of Star Wars The Clone Wars were wanting, it found its footing, and when Disney released the highly anticipated Season 7 in 2020, it did not disappoint. On its own, this series is a must-watch, but with shows like Obi-Wan Kenobi and Ahsoka coming to Disney+, it's more important than ever to make sure you're up to date on all canonic stories. So, with that said, here are 5 of the best story arcs in Star Wars The Clone Wars. I'm a sucker for Obi-Wan Kenobi, and I love hearing him say things like,
"We'll have to stand and fight, or in your case, just stand."
When Obi-Wan is reunited with the pacifist Duchess Satine, it's clear the pair have a history. In one of the best Clone Wars sequences, he's captured by Death Watch and it's left up to the Duchess to rescue him. It's a near miss, but Satine saves him in time. The pair continues to tread the line between arguing and flirting throughout the 3-episode arc. It's during the 2nd episode, Voyage of Temptation, that we see a new side of Obi-Wan Kenobi. After a lot of bickering back and forth, Satine finds herself held hostage. She tells Obi-Wan that she's always loved him, and he even admits that he would have left the Jedi Order for her. This whole arc adds a new dimension to Obi-Wan's character, and his interactions with Satine are my favorite scenes. Although their relationship is dysfunctional at best, I can't help but love the two of them together. Although this one hurts every time I watch it, it's amazing. Maybe that's even why it's amazing. The first time I watched Ahsoka being blamed for the bombing of the Jedi Temple and subsequently murdering a suspect, I couldn't quite believe that The Clone Wars was originally made as a children's TV show. As much as it hurts to watch Ahsoka walk away from the Jedi, it needed to happen. Her leaving was part of what pushed Anakin to the dark side, and we knew that she would need to be out of the picture before Revenge of the Sith. Seeing her work with Ventress and explore Coruscant's lower levels to clear her name is a constant guessing game, up to the very moment we discover that it's Ahsoka's friend and fellow Jedi, Barriss Offee, that betrayed her in the Order. When Ahsoka denies the offer to return to the Order and she parts ways with Anakin, it's heart-wrenching, and the top-tier score pulls the entire scene together.
I know.
Now we can watch this knowing that the pair will be reunited one final time, but that doesn't make it any easier. In a show named after the clones who fought in the war, it's only right that some of the best arcs center around the clones themselves. Umbara is a prime example of Star Wars at its best. It's also one of the darkest and most thought-provoking arcs in the show. What makes a good soldier? Blindly following orders or standing up to oppression? There's such a good depth of character, separating each clone as their own person while still keeping them in a cohesive brotherhood. This was a huge arc for the clones, as they faced the moral dilemma of disobeying orders and turning on a superior officer, especially after Jedi Pong Krell manipulated them to fire on each other. There's an intense divide between those of them who wanted to rise up and those who believe they should follow their orders. With a tight plot and some stunning visuals, Umbara easily earned its place on this list. It creates a larger narrative for the clones and only makes Order 66 even more menacing. We see the clones discover their autonomy, but we know that their implanted chips are destined to tear this away from them. If you ever needed proof that Anakin Skywalker is the chosen one, Mortis is it. This arc is so important to the larger plot of the Clone Wars, and the moment when Anakin brings the son and the daughter to heal is chilling. The story also makes the term bring balance to the Force much clearer. We also see how deep the bond between Anakin and Ahsoka is, and the future impact that her leaving the Order will have on him. When she dies, Anakin is willing to do anything to save her in that moment, so much so that the daughter gives up her life force for Ahsoka, something which has larger implications, but is a discussion for another day. What really cements Mortis, though, as one of the best arcs is that we preemptively see the fall of Anakin Skywalker. The son shows him all the pain and suffering he will cause as Darth Vader. Seeing what his future holds is enough to temporarily corrupt Anakin and turn him to the dark side. As viewers, we know this will happen either way, but that doesn't stop us from wanting Anakin to turn back to the light, even if only temporarily. When you combine these stunning Season 7 animation, motion capture, peak storytelling, and amazing characters, you get the Siege of Mandalore. The use of motion capture made everything in the Ahsoka Maul fight feel so real, and it's one of the best lightsaber duels in Star Wars. Ahsoka being reunited with Anakin, Obi-Wan, and the 501st is heartwarming, particularly when Anakin presents her with her lightsabers and seeing that the 501st painted their helmets in the style of her face markings. One of the best moments in all of Star Wars. However, heartwarming is in short supply with this story. It's quickly replaced with the looming shadow of Order 66 and the Empire. This arc has some of the best storytelling for Ahsoka and Rex, and we see what we never got to see in Revenge of the Sith, the impact that Order 66 had on the clones. We see the callback to Fives' discovery of the clones as inhibitor chips, and it's a relief when Rex is saved from this fate. When faced with Ahsoka and Rex standing over a graveyard of the 501st helmets, it's truly haunting, especially after we spent 7 seasons growing to know and love each clone as an individual. We knew that Order 66 was coming, but that didn't make it hurt any less to watch. The Clone Wars accomplished so much during its 7 seasons, including taking Ahsoka Tano from a forgettable, slightly annoying character to one of my all-time Star Wars favorites. If you haven't watched this series, do it immediately. What are your favorite story arcs from the Clone Wars? Let us know in the comments, hit that subscribe button, and as always, geek out.